know that I've been talking to you about stapler circumcision. Today I just thought I'll take you inside my operation theater and show you an actual procedure. This procedure is actually in real time. I'm not going to do editing, so you can actually understand the amount of time that it takes to do this procedure and how seamless the procedure goes. So I'm going to start now. We're going to show you the penis. So as you can see, this is a tight foreskin. So circumcision stapler is basically done for patients who have a tight foreskin, that is a phimosis. You can also see that the frenular area here is quite short. The frenulum and the shot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by opening up the foreskin here slightly, and I'm going to put snap forceps here, and so I'm going to try and release it slightly here to loosen this. Stapler circumcision device. Now it contains a plastic bell. So the plastic bell is actually going to go inside and protect the glans against any injury. So the plastic bell has to be held at an angle like this. You can see that the frenulum is quite short there, and it's actually pulling the glans just loose. Yeah, so I'm going to release it slightly more. That being done, now it's in position for this piece. Hold on. Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a loop and tie it around like that. So just release the artery forceps one by one. So I'm going to release the artery forceps. This is all tightened up here, and I'm going to cut off this excess thread. Now this is the stapler device. Now this device is going to go at an angle here inside and fixed over that. And you can see my assistant is actually putting a small knob and turning it clockwise just to tighten this. Tighten it further, and what I want to basically check is to make sure that there is no glans that is actually caught here, right? So we want to chop off only the foreskin and not any part of the glans penis here. So I can feel only the plastic bell. The glans is nice and safe here. Okay, so this is a protective device which needs to be taken off before the procedure is done. That comes off like that, and now I'm going to go ahead and engage this. Right, so this is all nice and tight. So I start compressing these two hands together. So I just need to ensure that this comes in nicely. This is quite smooth. So you see that I've completely compressed it, and I'm going to hold this in place for about 45 seconds to about a minute. So you see, this is what I've been doing. What I did was basically I put a plastic bell and then I put the device, and then I tied the foreskin, tightened it, and then I've compressed it. So the blade that is basically inside is cutting the foreskin right now. I'm applying squeezing pressure. So we wait for about like 45 seconds. So almost about 30-40 seconds done now. So we're going to release this. I'm going to unscrew this again. And I compress on the plastic bell, and I just remove that. So you see how beautifully this thing has been cut. All I need to do here is give
pressure for about 3 minutes, and this procedure is done. So the patient, so the actual time is about, say, less than 2 minutes to do this entire procedure. It's a very, very quick and easy and comfortable procedure. The patient won't feel any pain. Obviously, we've given him some kind of anesthesia. This patient undertook regional, but we have a lot of people we can do it under local anesthesia as well. This patient remains in the hospital for about 6 hours, and he is on his way back. And he can actually join work from tomorrow because it's absolutely zero pain. Pain scale of 1 to 10 is probably about like 1. That's about it. And that too is only because of the, you know, just because the glans is exposed after being covered. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please subscribe to us, and if you like it, like, you know, please share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.